What's good? You rocking with your boy Czar, All Rights Reserved. Shout to the Peaceful Attorney. That's my nickname for him. I don't always give my commenters blatant names, so they're not constantly getting messages and stuff. Now, as I've been informed by this attorney, is that Trayvon Newsom has lawyered up off the rip. This is a huge change in the game because, as I told you guys earlier, that what they do is they pull you in like a basketball team and they pass you back and forth. And what happens is when they're passing you back and forth, they're literally getting information from one or the other and comparing it. The fact he's lawyered up, they can't do this to him because he's going to be told by his attorney and his or his counsel, his lawyer, whoever it is, and I hope he paid for it versus the free one, that he's going to have to talk about different things, but not certain things he doesn't have to disclose. This is crazy because when we know how suspects have gone in and been arrested before, they had no counsel. Now we have a suspect that has wisened up and got counsel before he can be objective in any way, shape, or form to letting some information slip. Now, this is huge because him getting this puts it in a situation like, what evidence do you really got on me? And he can say he was scared for his life. He can say that he had threats. He can. There's many different ways he can address the situation in order for him to get out of having to say the questions that they're going to ask. Now, this is a very prevalent measure taken by criminals who are career criminals in answering questions by saying there was some reason why they were on the run or something. So now investigators just got a tough cookie. And in this, I mean, they're dealing with someone who isn't willing to take the steps they want in order to get the information they need in order for to validate whoever told the whereabouts or implicated this man in the situation. Remember, we have not seen footage. They may have footage on saying who it is, but remember, they were masked up. So the fact they were masked up, you'd have to look at build, you'd have to look for a tattoo, something that undoubtedly compares this criminal to the situation. This is bad. This is a bad thing because there's a lot of different situations that can be go awry. Because remember, I asked, what circumstantial evidence is there? Do they have direct evidence that he admitted he was part of this to someone? This is all going to be very important because we know for a fact that regardless of who is being claimed their name, there needs to be some type of direct evidence. Unless one of the people that told is willing to get on the stand and admit this man was with me in this plot, even then, the evidence still has to be strong against him. A good attorney is going to help you make the decisions you need to get away from this type of situation. Now, what is going on with these other suspects? You have Robert Allen saying he wants to tell the truth. You have somebody else who's standing back who's saying, well, nah, there's no truth to it. And you got another guy who we just don't know what's going on. So now this fourth suspect can't even be placed in a position to stand apparent and be blamed for anything that's happened except by, let's say, someone doing what everyone hates to do, no snitching. So snitching obviously has to be what's going on if any type of conviction is going to come out of the situation. Now, why is this bad? This is bad because if we sit back and investigators allow him to lawyer up, they're not going to get any information that they can cross-compare or cross-examine another person with, as well as the fact that if the evidence isn't strong, this lawyer is going to slide his guy out of this murder situation. So with no circumstantial, no direct, and a lot of variables out there, it's possible that some suspects can walk if they lawyer up the right way. Now, another person in a situation that could probably do the same thing would be Robert Allen, being that if he didn't already say something he shouldn't have said. And more than likely, the fact he didn't lawyer up, and if they put him in that interrogation room and he opened his mouth even a little bit, he said something he shouldn't have said. That's just the fact of the matter, because they're not going to walk in there and ask him any question that wouldn't be relevant to the case, let alone they'd have to have some type of evidence other than a video that is alleged to have come from an earlier point. See, and even if investigators were using these tactics, it was smart. I'm going to use some earlier photos, some earlier issues, and see if I can get him to talk. A lawyer would know to tell their suspect to keep quiet, but did he know or did he not know? It seems Trayvon Newsom knew. He knew as soon as he got picked up, he was going to have to be in a position where he could not get railroaded by any details. No factors could come out. And in order to get something out of him, it had to be in a lawful way that did not take away his constitutional rights. That is what I've been telling other people to do instead of talk if they believe they're innocent. Now, this is not good for investigators. This is like a game. Again, think of it like basketball. Him making this decision is a score on his part, because there's nothing to outwardly and blatantly compare him that is so, let's say, blatant to the point where lawyers don't matter. This is a game of lawyer. Now, this is a game in court. Now, this is a game of who's shooting the best shot. And by these details, by the nature of how fast he lawyered up, he may have very important information that won't come out, and that will be left in an array where they'll have to prove it. So now this is the game of investigators. Prove it. Prove that I was part of this. Prove that I had anything to do with this situation. This is a very bad position to be in, especially as investigators looking into something so critical and something so important. And that's why this couldn't wait to be talked about. I know that this guy you guys may think he's guilty or something, but we have to wait to see why he lawyered up so fast and what he tells his lawyer and what questions is he truly trying to avoid. This is no longer a game that's being played on investigators' court with Trayvon Newsom. Now, that's just one out of three others that they can still railroad. So it's possible they get the details to include him because these guys know they're going down. But again, that would be against the code of no snitching. We know this. So you guys were all involved in this crime together. But at the same time, you're saying that he's saying that he's not involved, and you're saying that he is. So this is going to be a very, very troublesome case for investigators to take on in any branch of law, any branch of court, in any situation. This is not what you want. This is not the type of issue you want to have to deal with, especially when it's dealing with a potential criminal. Now, the reason I brought this up so fast is not only because the peaceful attorney hit me up, but you guys got to understand, this is going to work a bunch of traction. So there's going to be a lot of information coming out faster because they're trying to get someone to blatantly link Trayvon Newsom to the crime. Not only link him, but expose him as someone who was involved, put him out there as someone who was an incredible asset to allowing this to happen to the superstar. There's too many variables still lying around. That's why word of mouth is now a powerful catalyst. So if three out of three link him to the scene of the crime, it won't matter what lawyer he has, because these three will be forced to hit that stand to go against him. So it can work against him for lawyering up so fast and avoiding to speak on situations that he was linked to. But at the same time, it could be a blessing for him if these guys really don't know or didn't see him or don't admit to anything. So it's still up in the air. I don't know how his relationship is with these guys, but it's real questionable right now. The question lies in who really was involved in the situation and how were they? Who did what? If he was a shooter, which is most natural for situations where, let's say, guys are trying to point you out and saying they didn't do anything, but you were still at the scene of the crime, so that's bad. That's bad to admit it. And the fact he's lawyered up, he never has to admit blatantly to anything or any type of involvement other than what his lawyer allows him to admit to a question. This is smart, but it's bad for investigators once again. This is not something that, as an investigation, you want to happen, but there's always tactics to work around these sort of things. And we'll look in the coming days to see what tactics they implement that will work in their favor. One of the main tactics that is used that investigators will do if someone lawyers up I'll hit the interrogation room and I'll tell you that literally your guy said this. It could be true, it could be false. But more likely, this deep into the case, it's all factual. Because they sent federal agents to search out this man, that he was, his face was put up. There is some type of evidence to link him to the scene. Whether it's direct evidence or circumstantial, we'll find out. But regardless, being at this deep in the game, it's going to be admissible, regardless of what it is, because they want to show that he was a part of this savagery. They want to show the pictures. They want to show his relations. They want to show premeditation if it exists. Now, if these guys start speaking up in a different way, and if Trayvon Newsom would admit there was a mastermind and stuff, this could be even more beneficial to him, because now he's telling us that he heard about something. He saw something on the news. He just saw his picture on the news and ran. That's a very normal way that a lot of criminals get out of getting away from the cops the way they did. I just say, look, I saw my picture out. I didn't know what it meant. I got scared because people started looking at me different, started trying to treat me different, and I knew I was innocent, but I couldn't get around to reaching you guys. I didn't know how to, which is a very common way that people can cover up the fact that they were getting away. But at the same time, if one of these suspects admitted he was there, it's not good. It's going to be a fight, and it's going to be against between suspects, them discrediting. So you're not just fighting the state. You're fighting against other suspects to not admit that your presence was there on the scene, nor admit any involvement of you. And they could say that, but you could say it wasn't me. But it's still going to be their word against yours. But lawyering up gives him the advantage in that situation, because whether they have a free lawyer or not, these guys have reason to involve someone else and not themselves. What's your thoughts on this case? What's your thoughts on him lawyering up? You think it proves guilt, or do you think it shows very high intelligence versus every other suspect we've seen get apprehended? You know how I rock. All rights reserved.